Reviewing the Brighton transfer window. It's fair to say it was a good one. £60 million worth of investments were made this summer, and I think it was very, very successful. We're strengthened in the areas which we needed to strengthen, and that was exactly how we planned out to be, and that's exactly who we signed in the end. Adding a new striker, adding a new experienced midfielder, adding a new defender, and sorting out the fullback situation in a little way of getting an under-23 fullback in all. Signing a creative winger in all from a Genk, I believe it is. It's been an amazing summer in my opinion, and in the end, I'll say it now, I think a grade our transfer business an A. Now, who have Brighton signed, may you ask? Now, a striker from Brentford, excuse the pronunciation, but I believe he's called Neil Morpay. I think. Bagged in about 26 to 28 goals in the Championship last season, which for any striker, no matter what league you're in, is unbelievable. And for him to have about 30 minutes under his belt yesterday, if fan, already get his Premier League debut goal against Watford in a 3-0 victory. Big things are yet to come for him. We also made a signing called Leonardo Trossard. He's a player from Genk. He was involved in a lot of goals last season, him included in the score sheet on a couple of times. He's a really creative midfielder, and I think that'll bring a lot of creativity to our team. He did not have a chance to get onto the pitch yesterday, but he was in the squad in general, and to bring off the bench is definitely the type of midfielder you want to bring on to change the game or something like that. His work rate is phenomenal, and in some pre-season games he's been fantastic so far, so his future for Brighton is yet to come, and I tell you what, I'm really excited for this signing, and I'm excited for him to get in action in the Brighton shirt. Webster from Bristol City is one where a lot of people are going a bit under the radar with, not just Brighton fans, but with fans in general. We started Burn yesterday instead of Webster, and that's probably because Webster's still getting settled in with Brighton, and actually Burn had a fantastic game yesterday as a back three with Duncan Duffy. But bringing a Webster in brings that nice depth into the squad where if you need a replacement, you've got him, or for example, if you want to swap it around, you've got Burn to come on instead of one of the defenders if they are injured, suspended, etc. like that. I've been told by a lot of Championship clubs last year, and especially Bristol City fans, that he's like the real deal and he's like a proper great defender with a bright future ahead of him, and him progressing in the Premier League for Brighton is hopefully the way it's going to be going, and I can't wait to see him in a Brighton shirt also, which will be great for us fans to see. Something we did not do is add Premier League experience, and adding Aaron Moy from Huddersfield on loan for the season is fantastic, and I'll tell you what, he may not get a lot of game time for Brighton, but I mean, what he has got is that Premier League experience and courage to do what he does best when he does come on for Brighton, if that needs be. If Stevens or Proper gets injured, I'll be more than comfortable with Moy starting and Moy playing in general, because I think to our style this season, he's going to be a massive fit and a massive aspect to our season this year. I don't know what Brighton fans make of this decision and make of the signings, but for me, I think it's an A for this one. As a rating, it is definitely an A. If you think about it, with Brighton spending £60 million and people writing us off with the signings made, people even rating him as like a C minus rating for our transfer window, don't even understand what's been going on in the transfer market for Brighton this year. I mean, like, yeah, okay, they may think Championship defender, Championship attacker, he's not going to do it in the Prem, is he? But I mean, you're always going to have them doubts. But look at the quality of them. They're not just like average Championship attackers. They are attackers and defenders in the Championship, which proved themselves highly, and they've now got that chance to prove it in the Premier League, which already one has done so far in his first 30 minutes playing for Brighton, already writing him off. It was a fantastic ball from Duncan. It was a fantastic finish and comfortably around the keeper. Proper striker's finish. And people are saying they're writing us off, and we're fourth in the league, come on. Okay, I'm joking. When I say we're fourth in the league, you know, I hope you know I'm not being deluded, and I don't actually think we're going to stay there at the end of the year, because I think we're going to win the league in general, so I mean, behave. We also signed a Portsmouth defender for about £7 to £8 million, but he's gone out on loan to Derby, which is good for him to get experience, and that's another option in the future which we have got. It's nice to see that we've signed like young players to then develop into our squad and develop in age in general. Like, that's why the price tag is quite high, because these players are quite young under good contracts at their clubs, which is going for high money. And I think these players in particular are like going to strengthen Brighton's squad massively. The depth in our squad is fantastic, and that is one people are really underestimating, Brighton's depth in the squad. And I think that is fantastic, which we've bolstered our attacking options, and Doney and Morpay coming on yesterday off the bench, both scoring, and Doney with the first touch in the Premier League this season for him. I mean, people are honestly writing us off, and we won 3-0 away to Watford. That's a big statement. They finished up like 8th last year. We finished about 17th last year. New manager, and people are writing us off and putting us above in the league in their predictions. Like, we're all entitled to our opinions, yeah. Like me putting, I don't know, Sheffield United bottom of the league, and Sheffield United fans may have different opinions. But I'm just saying, I just don't think people are getting the right Right, talking about Brighton, to be honest, I don't think they're getting the right story behind it all. They think, oh, Chris Hughton, fantastic manager, but Brighton are asking for too much or something by adding an attacking manager. Really know what's going on, do you? Even the pundits out there, the pundits don't even know what they're talking about sometimes. But I don't want to go too off topic. I'm going to put a comparison between Graham Potter and Chris Hughton into a separate video. So if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure drop a like on this video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. My rating for the transfers is definitely going to be an A for me. I think it's a fantastic window, and hopefully you guys enjoyed the video and agree with my points exactly the same. If you enjoyed it, make sure to drop a like. I'll see you guys in another video. Goodbye, guys.